Hello, we are going to walk you through an approach to insert multiple worksheets into an Excel workbook using a macro. We have source historical financials for the income statement and balance sheet, as well as a forecast sheet for our Canadian beverages entity. As most Excel users know, we can easily insert a new worksheet, but in this case, I want to add multiple worksheets because I will have financials for other business units. Go to Visual Basic for Applications and insert a new module for the macro we will compose. Option Explicit means we are forced to state the variables for our specific macro each time. It helps to avoid errors occurring at compile time. In other words, it helps to protect our macro from bugs. We will call our macro Insert Multi-Sheets. First, we should disable these three Excel properties because it will enhance the macro's performance. Next, we want to declare specific variables and their type for our macro, as this will ensure certain objects in our macro are using the correct type when the macro is running. It is another way to improve the macro's speed and accuracy and avoid unnecessary bugs or errors. We want to specify our initial worksheet where we have triggered the macro to run from. Start cell and start sheet will guarantee the cursor returns to the original worksheet once the macro has finished running. As described, the input box will prompt the user to stipulate the number of worksheets to insert into the workbook. This piece of code will help to mitigate against further error in the macro, where users incorrectly input a zero or negative value in the input box. In that case, the macro will simply end. This loop will insert the specific number of worksheets into the active workbook. This code is stating the inserted worksheets will be placed to the far right-hand side of the active sheet. As the narrative in green states, we will now move the cursor back to the initial worksheet because the macro has finished inserting the multiple worksheets. The macro has finished. We can now reset the three Excel properties back to their original state. Let's review our completed macro and ensure it is accurate and complete. We are ready to test the macro. Let's say we have four additional business units, hence we want to insert 12 sheets into our workbook. We can see our macro is correctly inserting multiple worksheets.